The Magi come from far. As we place them around the crèche of Jesus, I'd like to talk to you about how we often see green tape on the floor and green tape about spacing ourselves out to be distant from others, and green tape about where to stand and to receive communion or to go to the next bank teller. It has become all too familiar. Even as the snow falls, we still see remnants of bits of green tape. And yet, at this time, we often think of those who have traveled a great distance, those who were looking and guided by a star to find Jesus lying in a manger. They are there to be united, not to be distant, but to be close to Jesus. Jesus draws all sorts of people to him. And as even in his birth, we already see something that is to be told at the end of the gospel, that we as Christians would go out into the world, that we would spread the message of Christ resurrected, that this Epiphany is not only a great light that has been seen in the person of Jesus Christ, but is also something that we celebrate today, and Jesus continues to draw us closer together. May we continue to give thanks on this feast day for his life, for the life of his family, and for those who risk a lot of things, of their livelihood, of their well-being, to venture forth and to find Christ even in this day. Let us pray. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires are known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Eternal God, who by a star led wise men to the worship of your Son, guide by your light the nations of the earth, that the whole world may know your glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Midian and Ephah. All those from Sheba shall come, and they shall bring gold and frankincense, and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord.
Godspeed to God.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. This is the reason that I, Paul, am prisoner for Jesus Christ, for the sake of you Gentiles. For surely you have already heard of the commission of God's grace that was given me for you, and how the mystery was made known to me by revelation, as I wrote above in a few words. A reading of which will enable you to perceive my understanding of the mystery of Christ. In former generations, this mystery was not made known to humankind, as it has been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. That is, the Gentiles have become fellow heirs, members of the same body, and sharers in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this gospel, I have become a servant according to the gift of God's grace that was given me by the working of his power. Although I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to me to bring to the Gentiles the news of the boundless riches of Christ, and to make everyone see what is the plan of the mystery hidden for ages in God who created all things. So that through the church, the wisdom of God in its rich variety might now be made known to the rulers and authorities in the heavenly places. This was in accordance with the eternal purpose that he has carried out in Jesus Christ our Lord, in whom we have access to God in boldness and confidence through faith in him. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out. And there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This Epiphany, We have lots of little pieces that are dazzling. They're interesting. They're of different shapes and sizes, colors, and when we put them together inside our kaleidoscope, they make for a dazzling picture. And so I imagine that if we were to open up our kaleidoscope today after hearing some of the readings, this Epiphany kaleidoscope would have wise men in it, or magi, if you like the Greek. They're often seen as sorcerers or magicians or astrologers. That, you know, strangely enough, they're not referred to as kings. However, we might take a little piece of plastic and put it into our kaleidoscope in the shape of a crown, perhaps, and that might represent for us a king. Kings are often referenced in this feast day because we hear about them in the Psalms. The Psalm mentions them of kings that come from different lands and distant lands. And what about these travelers that we hear about? They also might be a piece of the story that we're told today. They come with gifts, like gold and frankincense, and they come with lots of camels. It's certainly good that we brought one of our own camels here today. Isaiah adds this piece to our story. And so as the Psalm and the prophet Isaiah, as well as even looking back at the Christmas narrative from Luke, we hear different pieces of the story. So in our kaleidoscope, we might think of shepherds, magi, kings, all of these people and places added to one. And when we shake it all about and we look through it, each of us might see something that's a little bit more different or fascinating or something that catches our eye as individuals. We roll it around and we see things of different importance. What I see when I view this kaleidoscope during Epiphany is Christ bringing things together. Christ bringing things that were distant and apart, he now brings them to himself. He draws Gentiles to himself from faraway places. He frightens rulers like King Herod, and even all the people of Jerusalem, it seems, are frightened about this news of a new king of the Jews. There is kingship that is present in his message as well that we hear in the Gospels. We hear about the gifts that the wise men bring, gold, frankincense, and myrrh, something that makes us think of and hear more about his kingship, his anointing, and his death. All three of those, gold, frankincense, and myrrh, are symbols for Jesus' life and ministry. And things come full circle at this gospel, when we are heard to proclaim that we are to go out to the ends of the earth and proclaim Jesus born, died, and resurrected. And that's an important message for us that is encapsulated right at the beginning of Matthew's gospel. But what about our own kaleidoscope? It's all well and good to have a kaleidoscope full of biblical imagery and different words and phrases, camels, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. But what is it in our own kaleidoscope that we can make sense of all of this in our own lives? I imagine that this time of year, if we were to stick things into our kaleidoscope that would give us some shapes and colors to look at, a big piece of that might be the Christmas shopping bill. That is something that we might all be dreading. It's going to come, perhaps. Maybe there is the promise to ourselves that we might put into the kaleidoscope about cutting back on the rich food. I know that I'm one of those people. Or perhaps thinking of all those piles of wrapping paper that might need to be recycled. Or maybe the odd Christmas card that we've forgotten to mail, but better late than never. maybe it's a piece of our Christmas tree, and that we need to strip it bare now that there's more needles laying underneath it than on the actual tree. All of these things, perhaps even all of our joys, our hopes, our worries, and our concerns, get placed into that kaleidoscope. It's not there to frighten us, but I know that if each of us picks up that kaleidoscope, we'll see something a little different that's unique to our own lives. But in order for a kaleidoscope to work, it needs light. And I think that where we find that light is the solution to our problems. The kaleidoscope needs light to make those pieces and those shapes come alive, to sparkle, and to fill us with awe. The Magi were guided by a star, guided by a light. But what they were really looking for was the one true light, Jesus himself. Now, if we think that if we look through our kaleidoscope of problems, of hopes, and concerns as through the light of Jesus, then we might view that passage, that all those bits and bobs, all the things in our kaleidoscope, it might come to mean and to see that things aren't so troublesome after all. That perhaps even in our darkest moments, the things that frighten us the most, the light continues to shine through. The light will continue to shine through. And I think that perhaps one way of doing this in your own homes to begin with is not necessarily to build a kaleidoscope, although you could, but to think of where that light emanates from your own house, from your own home. It's very much a tradition in many countries and in many denominations that the wise men or the magi come door to door and bless our houses, leaving a chalk message above our doorways, the threshold of our homes, that they might be a place of blessing and also a place where Christ is received and spoken about. I've got a little chalk piece that I'm going to stick on to our manger. On it, it says 20 plus, which is the cross, and it has CMB, which are the legendary names of the three wise men. And at this time, then, they bless our houses. You might also think of your house as blessed. So let us follow the star. Let us recognize Jesus. And let us offer our gifts to the Lord. And may his light be the light that shines in our homes and in our hearts. Amen. Let us confess our faith as we say, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, in accordance to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver. of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace from on high and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, especially in the Middle East, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Linda, our primate, Andrew, our bishop, for Reverend Chris and Canon Barrow, for our film crew, Phil Claxton and Marcus Thomas, and for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Elizabeth, our queen, for the leaders of the nations, and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this town of Newmarket, for every city and community, for those who live in them in faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For good weather and for abundant harvest for all to share, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, water, or air, for the sick and suffering, especially Father Mike, Melissa, David, Matthew, Pat, Cavell, Ron, Deanna, Sylvia, Joanne, Glenna, Marianne, James, Terry, for those afflicted by COVID-19, for prisoners and captives, and for their safety, health, and salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, strife, and need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all those who have died, especially those who have died from COVID-19 and from violence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering St. Paul and all the saints, we commit ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ our God, to you, O Lord. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time, with one accord, to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together, you will hear their requests. Fulfill now our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, eternal life. For you, Father, are good and loving, and we glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, in the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm in strength and all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Gracious God, accept the offering of your church, the hearts of your people joined in praise and thanksgiving, in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth. You have revealed your eternal plan for salvation and have shown your Son, Jesus Christ, to be the light of all peoples. Therefore, with angels and archangels, we raise our voices in joyful praise to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, Lord our God, for the goodness and love you have made known to us in creation, in calling Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all in the Word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, a death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we, made acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new. And bring us to that city of light where you dwell with all your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, the author of our salvation, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break the bread of life, and that life is the light of the world. God, hear among us, light in the midst of us, bring us to light and life. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sin of the world, grant us thy peace. Let us pray. God of all the nations of the earth, guide us with your light. Help us to recognize Christ as he comes to us in this Eucharist and in our neighbors. May we welcome him with love, for he is Lord, now and forever.
Amen.
Glory to God,
whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine.
Glory to God from generation to generation, in the Church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. May the God of infinite goodness scatter the darkness of sin and brighten your hearts with holiness. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen.
Thanks be to God.